Hello everyone, welcome to another review from Price Jugaad, and today we are going to spend ample time to review the battery and charging performance of the OnePlus 3, the fourth phone yet offered by OnePlus. There has been several occurrences where I've missed important calls or emails and messages just because my phone's battery had given up on me, and trust me, I value its importance from the core of my heart. I'll try to leave no ground and stress the battery all the way I can. Eventually, this should indicate how much it will last according to your daily usage, including playing games or browsing internet, listening songs and so on. It will help you to decide whether to buy this phone or not. We have this brand new model with us, as you can see, and while I love its amazing specs for the price, that's ₹27,999 in India and 1599 dirhams in Dubai and UAE, we'll take its battery for a ride and see how it holds up to the flagship. Enough talking, now let's get down to business. We'll run a few tests to optimally measure the performance of the battery and the charger from all aspects. I've drained the phone completely now and would charge it to check how it performs if I don't use it. Later, I'll completely discharge and charge it again while using it and see how it affects the charging time. Then we'll use the phone like a regular user would do on an average day to check how far the device would last on a typical day of yours without needing a second charge. For this, we should check the performance of the battery and the output of the charger by using the Ampere app on the phone. And also this more dependable USB power measurement device. So I've completely drained the phone's battery beforehand. It's 12:30 AM here right now and I shall start charging. The video will be time lapse so that increase in charge can be seen easily. The Ampere app shows that the charger is pumping in around 3200 mAh current at 3.9 volt. The pattern of charging that I have seen goes usually like the current is higher and the voltage is lower. Gradually at around 70 to 80% charge, the voltage starts to increase to about 4.2 and the current lowers down to as low as 500 to 1200 milliampere. So here at exactly 30 minutes, the charge has reached 60% and this looks incredible, just as OnePlus has promised. It's kind of exhilarating to experience dash charge for the first time. This breeds new possibilities of how you live your daily day usually, and more so when you travel. We'll let the charge flow and see when it touches 100. So the charge has reached 85% now in about 43 minutes and the current has started to drop. It's at 1800 milliampere now, as you can see, and this as a result would slow down the charging process. The battery left time mentioned in the graph is of little use and keeps on underestimating the remaining time to full charge, especially at the end of the charging process. So at 98% charge here, the charging has got really slow at 480 milliampere. And I'm guessing it would take another 5 to 10 minutes to touch 100. So here we go. We have finally touched 100 at the 70 minute mark since we started charging. It's still impressive, I must say. It's pretty cool to see the short time of charge. For most of us, waking up, plugging the phone in, and while you get ready for the day, the phone will be suited up and ready for action too. I've experienced a little heat while the charging took place. That's definitely fine. Okay, time for experiment number 2. I have the completely discharged phone with me here again. It just shows 1% charge left with it now. I'll casually use the phone while charging it and check how it performs. The time now is 11:44 AM and here we go again. So it's 31 minutes now and the phone is charged to 60%. As we can see, the music does not really affect the dash charge performance. From the battery meter here, you can see that the phone reports the remaining time to charge around 21 minutes from here, and that's fine for our expectations. But from our previous experience, I think it will still take another 40 minutes. So I'll stop the Ghana.com app now, and for the next 10 minutes I'll use the YouTube app to play some videos and leave it to that. For the rest of the times I'll be playing music again. So the phone now is finally charged, and this time and the time is 12:59, so it has taken exactly 75 minutes to charge this time. We expected a higher time to charge, but it's just higher by 5 minutes. We really, really wanted to see this because many of us would leave the phone in the room in the morning, play some music to fill up the silence, and it is a spectacular case of how all of us use our phones. Let's dig in more now and get to how the phone performs in terms of battery life. So here comes our big test. We are now going to test the phone by simulating how an average user uses a phone by exposing it to different scenarios. Our device method of testing this includes making calls, browsing on 4G, Wi-Fi browsing, gaming, use of social applications, navigating using GPS, and lastly video playback. Throughout this experiment, as usual, we have hooked up the device to the 4G network of Reliance Jio. It is now 1:16 PM and we'll disconnect the charger and place a call and check the battery left after 40 minutes. The Volte call has been started. So it has been 40 minutes now and I'll hang up. The battery reports a drop of just 4% during this time. That's pretty cool since Volte is known to consume battery juice more than 3G and 2G. It's 1:56 PM now and we'll proceed, and I'll put the phone through some browsing action. I'll be using 4G data for around 20 minutes and then another 40 minutes on Wi-Fi. I'll speed up the video while I do some more browsing. It's been 20 minutes and it's 2:18 PM now and the battery has dropped from 96% to 88%. That's an 8% drop. I've just switched the phone from 4G to Wi-Fi and I'll repeat opening the websites again for the next 40 minutes. So the power level is right now at 71%, so that's a total drop of 17% for the last 40 minutes of intense browsing on Wi-Fi, and that's pretty decent since the screen on time for the phone has been around a little more than 1 hour and 42 minutes. It's time now to play some videos, and I'll open up the Hotstar app here and play a movie on 4G and watch it for the next. So it's been another 30 minutes now, and while I've been really enjoying the movie, I can't really keep you guys waiting. Let's proceed, and here we see that the battery now at 63% from 71%, and that's a drop of 8% while watching a 30 minute video on Hotstar. Next, we take the beast outdoors for a 30 minute ride. We have got Ramari over here with a bike, and we'll navigate our way using Google Maps. We'll make this fast just to check how the GPS drains the battery. We'll head out to the GVK1 mall that's very popular in Banjara Hills right away and come back from there. The battery is at 62% and it's 3:28 p.m. here and we are just on our way. We see the battery gradually dropping at the top and we'll see how much of it remains when we get back. So we have just reached our destination, the GVK1 mall at 3:38 p.m. right now, with a drop of 4% battery with the screen at full brightness. We used an internal road to avoid the traffic. We'll now head back to our office right away. Google reports us heavy traffic in here. That's good probably. This should allow us more time to test the GPS. Okay, so we have arrived and the battery is now at 50%. So there was a total drop of 12% battery on using the GPS for 23 minutes. The highest level of screen brightness must have been a factor, and on extrapolating this drop, the device would probably last around 3.5 hours on GPS with full brightness from 100% charge. On a lower brightness, it should last around 4 to 5 hours, and that's pretty impressive for us. Next, I'll open and browse Twitter for 20 minutes, and here we go. So after 20 minutes of using Twitter, the battery is now at 41%. That was a 9% drop. I'll go ahead and play the Asphalt 8 game for the next 15 minutes. It's pretty heavy on the phone's resources. And it's 4:18 p.m. now and we'll start. So in summary, the phone not only lasted through our daily use test, but shined through. We can be sure that this device would certainly last through an average daily use for you. This certainly means a lot to us, seeing this performance firsthand, and this is a major feature of the device that's left somewhat unadvertised by OnePlus. So as we saw, charging takes around an hour, irrespective of whether you are using the device or not, and it manages to power itself up from 0 to 60% when using the dash charger in 30 minutes flat. Also, talking on 4G for 40 minutes, viewing videos for another 30, browsing for an hour, using Twitter on Facebook for 20 to 30 minutes, and navigating using maps for another half an hour, and then again gaming for another half an hour would make the device last for at least 12 hours, if not more. Personally to me, the battery life looks pretty good, at least as per OnePlus's claims to the phone lasting one day of regular use. Sometimes you'll do need a charger during the day, mostly when you are navigating more or watching too many videos. But the 30 minute dash charge makes it a breeze to charge a device up to 60%. We feel that the need for the dash charger is a little more inconvenient since you will need to carry it everywhere you go. But well, conveniences do come with a price tag, and the sleek and trendy charger might not be a mess to carry around. We'll leave you to decide here. I've also attached screenshots of the battery meter I've captured at every step of the test, so it's easy for you to decide for yourself. May the force be with you. We'll see you in the next edition of Price Yoga's video.